Are you sobbing uncontrollably all of a sudden and you're not entirely sure why? Are your arms getting loose? Is your head falling into your hands? Could it be because this song plays during the trailer for the final season ever of Schitt's Creek, Love Like a Sunset Part 2 by Phoenix? If you haven't seen the trailer, it's really moving. The Rose family, Johnny, Moira, David, and Alexis, fancy clothes, holding hands, walking towards the Rosebud Motel. And if you haven't seen the show, Schitt's Creek is sort of like the little engine that could. It became this humble Canadian series set in a tiny town, and it's kind of exploded. It has a huge fan base outside of this country. The Guardian called it a quiet marvel. I saw Seth Meyers one time call it the best show that no one's talking about. It's won a whole bunch of Canadian honors, 4 Emmy nominations, 2 Screen Actors Guild nominations. And now the show is about to stroll off into the sunset. The final season of Schitt's Creek premieres tomorrow night. Annie Murphy plays Alexis Rose. She's picked up another nomination. Best Supporting Actress in a Comedy at the Critics' Choice Awards. And she's here. Hi.
Hi, bud.
How are you feeling? Are you doing all right?
Yeah, I'm doing all right. It's weird. I feel like once March rolls around, when we usually start shooting again, and I'm sitting there twiddling my thumbs, that will be when everything kind of gets real.
Yeah. Because you're still kind of working right now, right?
Still kind of work. Yeah, we're still doing press and seeing each other a whole bunch. So it wasn't like a full Band-Aid rip, which is nice.
Annie, when you started on the show, I think we knew each other then. Yeah. And I remember like knowing that you were going for some Canadian show or something like that. What did you think about it when you first sort of went for it?
Well, so I was in LA for pilot season and things were not going well.
No?
I'll tell you that much.
What do you mean not going well?
Well, so to paint a little picture, my apartment had just burnt down.
Right.
I hadn't worked in about 2 years.
Right.
I had just blown my very, very first screen test, like really blown it.
Do you mind if I ask what happened?
Walking in, forgetting every single line that I had,
right.
Asking to start again, then just saying, actually, I don't think I know this.
I don't mean to laugh, sorry.
Yeah, no, it was terrible.
Right. And your house burned down?
And my house burned down. And so I was just kind of like, ooh, well, the universe is saying pretty loudly to do something else. And then I got this audition for Schitt's Creek. And on the breakdown for the audition, it said Eugene Levy and Catherine O'Hara were attached to the show. And kind of my heart stopped beating and then fell out of my mouth because these were two people that I had just so, so admired for such a long time. And so I knew, like anything they touch turns to gold. So I knew it was going to be something really, really special.
Really?
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah, the premise was great. And, mm-hmm. they're in it. And Chris Elliott was in it. And mm-hmm. But I didn't really know what it would become.
When did you start realizing that it had become something pretty special?
I think it really started snowballing after the show got added to Netflix.
Like, yeah.
CBC and Pop were so beautifully involved, but then Netflix just kind of opened the doors.
Pop is the American station that the show airs on.
Yeah. So, as soon, like the day that we got added to Netflix, it was just kind of obvious that something big was happening.
How did you notice it?
Social media, bud.
Yeah?
Just followers and followers and retweets and ads and all this stuff.
Really? You saw a spike?
Yeah. Oh, big time. And then, you know, people like Tony Hale.
From Veep and Arrested Development.
Veep and Arrested Development started tweeting about it. And then it kind of started getting into the hands of celebrities in Hollywood. And
I mean, can I say this? Am I allowed to say this? It's so rare for things in Canadian television to work out.
Am I allowed to agree with that?
Yeah, I don't know. If not, we'll cut it. But it really did.
Yeah, it really did.
I realize people may not be that familiar with the show necessarily. So this is originally the premise was just a very rich family loses all their money, having to resort to living in this small town they once bought as a joke. And I think that sort of premise was what we all thought the show was. But the show has an incredible amount of heart, a incredible amount of love, an incredible amount of stories. And I feel like your character started as one thing, this sort mm-hmm. of like Paris Hilton-y socialite,
yeah.
and has become something else. Tell me a little bit about the development of your character.
Well, when I first got, when on that same breakdown that said Eugene Levy and Catherine O'Hara, it described Alexis and it was, you know, kind of blonde, ditzy socialite, on paper, not you know, not a great person, I would say. Not someone you'd really want to be around, quite selfish. And but as the series progressed, and I have the writers to thank a lot for this, is we got to kind of peel back the layers of her character. And you know, as everyone possesses many, many different facets of themselves. They're not just one tier.
Yeah.
And so I got to kind of explore that. And I think so much of Alexis kind of pre-Schitt's Creek was environmental. She was surrounded by very shallow, fickle people. She was surrounded by money. She was dependent on men and yachts and those kinds of crazy adventures, and that formed her up until that point. But when she was taken out of that environment and plunked into Schitt's Creek, we kind of start to get to see who she really is. And she actually does, very deep down, have a very kind and generous and unselfish soul. But you really kind of had to, like, mine for that over the seasons.
I'm happy you're talking about who she is deep down. I want to play this. Take a listen.
Oh, you're like a big, dirty raccoon, David.
Ew, no, David. Nom nom for us, David.
Never say nom nom again.
Oh, yay, David! Yay!
You try parallel parking in a burqa, David.
That's a cute little wood thing, David.
David! David!
Stop yelling, David!
That is a little bit of Annie Murphy playing Alexis Rose.
There she is.
I think that's summarizing Alexis' relationship with her brother David really well. But you can also tell there's a really great connection between you and, of course, the character, but also you and Dan.
Yeah.
Dan Levy, who plays David.
Old DL. Yeah.
Keep it on the DL, we call him.
I tell him that all the time. He never does.
No, it doesn't return my text, to be honest. I know.
Yeah. Story of my life.
Okay, go on.
No, Dan and I met for the very first. So when I got the audition, I was like, "Well, at the very least, I will get to meet Eugene Levy."
Yeah, that's what I said when I got this show.
Yeah,
I said, "You know what? Probably won't work out, but at the very least, I get to meet Eugene Levy."
The old star will be here. So I walk into the audition. I'm so excited, and it's Dan sitting there, and I was like, "Oh, God." Met Dan, ended up...
There's a guy who kind of looks like Eugene.
Yeah, I guess they have the same eyebrows. I guess that'll have to do. But then we did our chemistry test together, and he read with me for the chemistry test. And that's the first time we really kind of got to properly interact. And we just had this weird chemistry right out of the gates. Like, I've kind of tried to explain it as we knew each other in a past life, and I was perhaps his nagging mother, and he was my, you know, petulant son, or we were married for like 75 years or something like that. Like, there was a weird, weird connection where we knew how to push each other's buttons and, like, get under each other's skin and, right. And you know, maintain a loving relationship.
Right.
So, yeah, it was just kind of faded, I think, that we got to work together.
Give me like three or four words that describe Alexis.
Oh, man. Joyful. Confident. And handful.
How much of Annie Murphy is in Alexis?
I think we share a similar quality in the sense that we both look for the positive in a situation. And I mean, I at least try to do that.
I want to take you back to season 5. Take a listen to this.
Are you ready? Let's do it. I'm a Lamborghini. I'm a Hollywood star. I'm a little bit tipsy when I drive my car. I'm expensive sushi. I'm a cute, huge yacht. I'm a little bit single, even when I'm not. I'm a little bit. I'm a little bit, I'm a little bit, I'm a little bit of la, 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 la.
That is Alexis performing her single, A Little Bit Alexis, for an audition at the local production of Cabaret. That is going to be a really kind of famous moment in the show's history, of Schitt's Creek's history. Tell me a little bit about that scene.
When we were at the table read for this scene, all it said in the script was Alexis performs A Little Bit Alexis. Doesn't go into any detail. And I think because Noah Reed, the season before had been able to do this beautiful cover of Simply the Best, and he'd kind of been given the reins to do it.
You're simply the best. Better than all the rest.
I was like, I can do this myself. So I called up two of my boyfriends in the band Colorado, and we went into the studio for a few days, and I wrote the lyrics to the song, and then Menno and Nyx kind of helped me with all of the stuff I had no idea, the music and the production and all that stuff. And we knew that it had to be a joke, and we knew that it had to be a spoof, so we listened to Britney and Paris and all these women who came out with these songs, which we did love. But at the same time, all three of us secretly wanted to make a banger. We just really wanted to make a good song. And so we pulled out all the stops and did all the poppy hooks and everything. And we created, for better or for worse, a bit of an earworm. And I've had people cursing me for it, because it really gets stuck in there, especially the la-las.
What's been a scene that's been challenging for you to do emotionally? Has been, because like I said, the show is not, we all thought it was just going to be like a comedy about class or something, but it ended up being quite an emotional show. Can you think of a scene that's been hard to get through?
Oh, I never have been able to successfully accomplish crying, which is not great for an actor. You should really be able to kind of do the whole range of things.
You can't cry on command?
No, Tom, I can't. Until this moment, at one of the final scenes in the show is a very emotional one. And I worry now in the finale, people are just going to witness Annie Murphy and Dan Levy just airing their, like, just going through therapy, basically. Like, we're not in character. We're just kind of fully weeping in the scene. So it was hard to keep personal emotion out of it, because the scene didn't call for snotty, snotty, violent hysteria. And we were both kind of riding the wave of that.
Right.
So to kind of neutralize that, and that was a tough one.
You felt it come over you, though, it sounds
like. Big time, yeah.
Like, it felt like, it sounds to me like you weren't acting anymore.
No. As unprofessional as that sounds.
Let's talk a little bit about Eugene Levy and Catherine O'Hara. They play your parents, Johnny and Moira Rose. Like you said, you saw that Eugene and Catherine were attached to this. That's why you were kind of excited about doing it. Do you think you've learned from them?
Oh my God, yes. I learned. I was schooled every single day of work.
Like what?
First and foremost, their kindness. They are incredibly kind and generous and respectful of every single person on set. And that is such a thing that I hope to take away with me. Just treating everyone, no matter who, if they're a PA, people shouldn't be ranked on set. There shouldn't be, everyone should be treated with the same generosity and kindness and acceptance. And they do such a beautiful job of that. And also their sense of play when they're work, like they've been working together for 45 years.
Oh my God.
And because I guess they both have that improv background, they love to just play around and experiment and try things, and maybe it's going to work, maybe it's not, but at least we're giving it a shot. And they're beautiful professional actors, but also there's that sense of joy all the time when they're working. Even if it's a tough scene or a tough day, they always find the fun in it. And I've just loved watching that in them.
Obviously, it's such an intimidating thing, hey, to walk into a show with those two people.
Yes. And I think when I got the part, I was so excited, first of all, to have booked a job, and second of all, to have booked a job with these two people, that I didn't really realize until basically the night before I had to start shooting that I would have to actually work with them.
Yeah.
Go in and be
on their level.
Their world,
yeah.
and on their level, hopefully. Basically, after that first day of school/work, it just felt like family, as cheesy as that sounds.
Well, speaking of family, I want to take a listen to this.
My favorite thing on set is watching Dan's dad, Eugene, back at the monitors, watching Dan and his sister, Sarah, act.
Eugene gets this huge grin on his face, and he starts mouthing their lines like a proud dance mom. And he's just beaming with pride.
That's you on stage at the GLAAD Awards. You were giving Dan Levy a special award for his work in making Schitt's Creek a homophobia-free zone. So Dan Levy plays one of the few, maybe only, pansexual characters on Canadian television?
I think you might be right.
Okay, so what's it been like for you to be a part of a show that's breaking ground like this? Are you hearing from people?
Very
much. Not just in the industry, but this must mean so much to people who watch the show.
Yeah. It's been so amazing to have a job and then to have a job that I am proud of. But then on top of that, to have a job that is impacting people on a level that's so much more than entertainment. We get, and Dan in particular, but we all have gotten letters from people who, after watching the show, have felt the courage to come out to their families, or parents who have accepted their kids because after seeing how Johnny and Moira have treated their queer son. And we've been getting letters from people going through chemotherapy treatment who have said that, you know, this is the show that kind of got them through the hard times and has brought them happiness and hope. And so it's been a very, very, very special experience because of that.
I'm still stuck on what you said to me earlier, that your apartment had burned down. You had kind of botched a really bad audition in L.A. You hadn't booked anything in two years.
Yeah.
It didn't look good. Like, if you could go back now and talk to that version of Annie the day before she auditions or gets the audition, what would you say?
Honestly, looking back, I wouldn't have changed anything at all. It was a really, really, really formative part of my life. And it makes this part of my life so much more incredible. I'm really just holding on to all the good as long as it lasts.
And you're going to keep any, are you going to take anything from the set?
Oh, I've stolen many things from set.
Yeah, you've been selling them online.
And
making for some good
big
money.
Bucks.
Yeah, it's been pretty good.
It's a whole new. I'm going into this business now of just hawking merchandise.
Thanks for the belt.
But I got a lot more where that came
from.
You're
going to take some stuff with you.
Yeah.
Hey? Anyway, I'm glad.
Yeah.
Annie Murphy plays Alexis Rose on Schitt's Creek, season 6, the final season.
Woo! I don't know what reaction you want from me right now.
I don't know. I want you to be
it's
real about it, buddy.
It's a mix.
Premieres tomorrow on CBC TV. If you got something catching up to do, head over to Jim. They've got all 5 seasons waiting for you.